Tag team action is on the way as part of our main event here tonight, and the fans are already going wild.
I'll tell you right now, I mean, the reaction that the Tabarnak, the team, got when they came out, it gave me chills, gave me the goosebumps, and we are ready for a fight, Twiggy.
An unusual pairing of Evil Uno and Dirty Bucks Belmar. Will they be able to coexist? They've had problems in the past. Taking on a seasoned team, Mathieu Saint-Jacques and Thomas Dubois.
Just waiting for the bell to ring here.
We are only moments away from this main event getting underway here in Gatineau, Quebec.
Looks like it's going to be Bucks Belmar and Thomas Dubois starting things off.
Two men that are very familiar with each other.
I mean, all four men in this ring, right? They've been on the scene a long time.
They have been beating each other, battering each other from city to city to city. And Mathieu's got something to say, so we're going to go down to ringside.
We're trying to get Serge to speak French. Give me a break. This guy's a moron.
I'm not even sure he speaks English.
Nobody understands, Serge. You can't even count the three. Competent all night.
And the match is officially underway. It is main event time. Thomas Dubois, Dirty Bucks Belmar starting things off for their respective teams. Who do you like for this one, Big Magic? You know all four of these competitors very, very well.
I mean, off the top of my head, my gut's telling me TDT, obviously, right? They've been a team for the better part of 10 years. Bucks and Uno. Uno's been a tag team wrestler for the majority of his career, right, with Stu Grayson.
Well,
Bucks, I mean, I don't know. He's held some tag team championships throughout in the province of Quebec.
Absolutely.
But you got to give the edge to TDT. And this is something you see. This piece of trash, this filthy piece of trash, every single match he tries to play mind games like this.
Well, you want to talk about having the advantage. That's part of the game. It's mind games, right? We have the team of Tabal Magda team, Mathieu, Saint-Jacques, and Thomas Dubois. They have the size advantage. They have the strength advantage. So we have to find a way, if you're Bucks Belmar and Evil Uno, to have some form of an upper hand here. And it looks like it worked, as he's got a handful of Dubois' face just rubbing in his grime. Side headlock off to the ropes. Big leapfrog from the big man. Drop down. Big boot to the face. Shades of the young Ray Traylor.
Left-handed boot right there. The big boss man.
He's got him closed in the corner. Oh, a real deep knife edge chop followed by a real sharp one.
The thing about Dubois, he's the power of the team. He's the agility of the team. He's an unbelievable professional wrestler. You do not want to be in there with this guy when he's rolling. Okay?
That's exactly.
Can he keep it together upstairs? He will make a mistake. Much like I said about Vanessa Craven. You can hang in there long enough, the man will make a mistake. In a tag team match, that's where he's going to want to tag out.
Well, it doesn't look like he's making any mistakes right now. He's doing a number on Bucks, and he sends him right into his tag team partner's boot. This is where TDT starts to go to work. They're going to send their opponent out and back in.
To me, you want to keep Dubois in there because he will make that mistake. If I'm Dubois, you want to make the quick tags in and out. And if I'm Uno or Bucks, you want to pound on Dubois. Well, you know he's the bigger guy, but he's bound to make a mistake. Saint-Jacques is a smarter wrestler. He's a brawler.
If you're either team, you want to make the quick tags in and out. You want to keep people fresh. We've seen how cardiovascular problems can lead to losses tonight. So I think if you're either team, to follow up on your point, you're going to want to go in and out. As we have a side headlock here.
Who's going to take the first cheap shot? That's what I'm looking to see. That's the team that's going to win my respect.
I certainly don't think either of these forces are opposed to taking cheap shots as we've got a tackle exchange here.
Who's going to take the shot first? That's what I want to see. Who wants it more?
Saint-Jacques sends Uno down, followed up by a big senton. He's sizing him up for something, trying to get these fans here at the Zeho set amped up. Is he wasting too much time? Now you want to talk about a cheap shot. Uno right there.
There you go. Nothing wrong with that right there. Nothing but respect for player Uno. That's how you got to wrestle. When you're on the ropes, when you're reeling, you do what you got to do.
Doesn't seem like it's enough to keep Saint-Jacques down. He's just hammering away. Here
all hell's
comes
gonna break
now.
Loose right here.
That's exactly it. This is breaking down into a street fight right here.
Buffoon Serge is going to have his hands full.
Uno gets sent into his partner corner to corner. TDT's up to something, and I don't think it's something good right now. Something is about to bode very badly for Evil Uno and Bucks Belmar as Saint-Jacques goes in big avalanche, sends Uno in for a line, a second line, a third line, and TDT is rolling.
A smart move right there. Uno and Bucks.
You've been talking about all night taking a breather,
it's
and that's
about
exactly
time that somebody did it. Seasoned veterans, timeout.
Well,
you want to do
this
a peacock?
I don't know if this is on purpose.
Doesn't matter. Get out of the way, boys. And TDT not going to let them do it. Not going to let them do it. You want to get out of the way right here. They're going to do it. They see it coming.
You have to wonder if that stomping in the ring that TDT was using to rally the fans kind of tipped off Bucks Belmar and Uno. Able to evade those double dives that TDT's known for.
They're leaving.
They're leaving.
I don't mind it.
They're going home.
They're
going home.
Things aren't going your way. There's no shame in quitting.
TDT running backstage. We've got a view here, and there's an all-out melee going on behind us as Uno gets sent out first with Mathieu Saint-Jacques. Now, this is where the officiating...
I don't understand it at all. You let them walk. You're the winners by countout. You get the winner's purse. You go home happy. I don't understand this move at all, and I don't like it.
Well, I think the answer is pretty simple. Thomas Dupont and Mathieu Saint-Jacques, they're proud competitors. They didn't come all the way from
Saint-Quebec
to win by a countout and cheat these fans out of their hard-earned money.
Cheat nothing.
If we know anything about TDT, they like fighting as much as they like winning. So the fact that you think they're going to let their opponents walk out and go home, you're sorely mistaken.
I don't understand. Their accountant's not going to like it, I'll tell you right now.
They're beaten. Their opponents into the audience. Mathieu takes a big gulp of beer as Bucks Belmar gives a huge shot. He caught Saint-Jacques coming around the ring.
Anything can happen in these brawls. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know where your opponents are. You're on one guy. The next guy can be behind you. You're going to roll an ankle. It's a recipe for disaster tweaking.
This is where things are so dangerous. You want to talk about the squared circle being
They're fighting
dangerous.
The elements right now.
We've got turnbuckles, we've got cables, we've got ropes, we've got posts, the canvas. The ring itself is made of cold hard steel and plywood. That's dangerous. You subtract that, and what do you have on the outside? We've got a solid wood floor here. There's a bar, there's fans, there are chairs. Anything could happen out here. This is unpredictable as we got Dubois and Uno in our vantage point, as we got Belmar and Saint-Jacques at the other side of the room. I can't believe it.
Are we going to be going back into the ring here?
TDT converging with their opponents.
All four men in front of the ring. Oh.
Look at that. You want to talk about cheap shots. It didn't
work.
A big back suplex. We've seen that a couple times tonight. The wrestlers have been taking notes.
Looks like you're setting them up for a big jump here.
They're sitting Bucks and Evil Uno down, and it certainly ain't for dinner, I'll tell you that much right now.
I still don't understand why they didn't just let them walk away. This match was over, and now you're about to fly. It's going to cost you.
Two big boots to greet Let's have out Nekta team as they both come off the ropes. What do we got here? A double Death Valley driver. That's exactly it.
I bet they wish they would have let them go now, huh?
No, I don't think they wish that at all. In what universe do you think that...
That's just like you. You're all full of honor.
Yeah, well, that might be a way.
Pride.
That might be a way that you're looking to win a matchup, but that's not the way TDT is looking to win.
Look what it's got them.
Saint-Jacques and Uno jockeying for position here in the middle of the ring as Uno takes a big handful. Looks like he's got the eyes, maybe a bit of the beard there. And that's where the beard can be a disadvantage for Dubois and Saint-Jacques as Dirty Bucks Belmar is doing just what his partner did on the apron.
You pull the beard. You pull anything you can. You pull the stupid suspenders. You choke them with it.
Well, that's exactly what's happened. And you mentioned cheap shots earlier, and we've seen a few out of Belmar and Evil Uno thus far tonight, and there's probably more to come.
You know, I respect this team now. You know, they're not too proud. They're not like you, Twiggy. You and your pride. It's always been your problem.
Saint-Jacques is reeling. Looks like he may have injured that hand during that brawl, perhaps. So we got a snapmare.
Look at this. They could have been in the car by now on the way home. Comfortable. Getting some food.
In any event. Belmar's in full control here as Saint-Jacques reaches, and these fans are rallying to make that tag to his partner, Thomas Dubois, here.
Cutting the ring in half. That's what you gotta do. That's what good teams do.
Belmar catching some steam. Huge flying knee. Now this is the first elongated advantage we've seen from either duo right now, and this has got to be right up your alley as a tag team specialist
in Magic. Absolutely what you got to do. It's what all the great tag teams do, and quite frankly, I'm impressed that Uno and Bucks Belmar had the presence of mind to do this here.
Well, the
they're
thing
doing
is,
it to the masters of the game,
it
right?
hasn't been pretty. They haven't been using a lot of moves. They haven't been using a lot of holds. They're just doing down and dirty damage to their opponents, and it's working.
They're just doing what they gotta do.
The quick tags that you alluded to earlier that you felt would be able to be on the behalf of TDT are being implemented by Uno and Belmar, who just eat a double DDT courtesy of the stockier of the two men. And that's enough for a tag. Here comes the House of Steam.
Oh boy. Giant belly to belly.
Superman punch. The freshman is on fire. Clothesline. Another clothesline. He's just gonna go back and forth, bringing the pain to Evil Uno.
Get carried away here.
Is this where you think the mistake is gonna come into play?
That's exactly what I'm talking about with Thomas Dubois.
Huge capture, Uranagi. What in God's name is this? Is he going for Hurricane Rana? Not only does he land the Hurricane Rana on Evil Uno in the process, he moonsaults onto Belmar, who was laying below. What do we have here? Huge.
You gotta give it to the
jackhammer.
Guy. You gotta give it to a guy that'll do it right now.
Not enough to keep Belmar down. The thing that you can't discredit is Belmar has held championships all across Ontario and the province of Quebec, and it's not for nothing. He's a very, very, very astute in-ring tactician. Another cheap shot. You must be loving this one.
And of course Serge didn't see it, right?
Well, he hasn't seen a lot tonight,
unfortunately.
He's a buffoon.
Where's the... Got to get the athletic commission. Who hires these officials?
Overhead throw from Belmar as we got Evil Uno.
Who's the legal man here? It doesn't even matter at this point.
Launching himself. Huge senton bomb. Thomas Dubois has been turned into a pancake as Belmar looks to capitalize, and it's only good for two.
And this is what I was saying earlier. The longer Dubois stays in there, the odds go up that he's going to make a mistake, and he finds himself here in a lot of trouble right now.
So are you saying you've never made a mistake in the ring, Magic?
Never made a mistake.
Never, huh?
17 years, Twiggy, I've never made a mistake.
How many?
So I've won championships all over this province.
Are you undefeated?
All over Canada.
Are you undefeated?
It doesn't matter.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought.
It doesn't go your way, as you've seen tonight.
Head of steam, not enough. Belmar catches him with a low knee to the midsection as he's only inches away from tagging his partner. You want to talk about using everything to your advantage. Evoluto using his teeth and just cracking the fingers and knuckles.
It seems to be a trend in wrestling, eh, these days? Breaking the fingers. Oh, that's how you fight right there. Look at this, getting nasty here, Twiggy.
This is truly broken down into a grudge match in Gatineau.
I love to see that. I love it.
I want to admit something here. I'm a little shocked at the state that the Tabalnagda team is in. Usually they're true specialists, as we mentioned in the past. And right now, Belmar and Uno have them exactly where they want them as they attempt a double clothesline, catch them with a throat thrust.
Here's the thing. I mean, TDT, they're a team that wrestles a lot, right? They have a lot of miles on them. They're wrestling every weekend, twice a weekend, three times a weekend, every weekend.
True.
And eventually it's going to catch up to him. Maybe that's what we're seeing right now.
Look at this. Belmar has got Dubois right where he wants him. He's slowing things down. He's got him in a body scissors, wrenching away at the neck and the face and the head. Belmar looking for the tag. See, now this is where you see some inexperience, a bit of miscommunication between Belmar and Uno.
It's all right. They still got it.
Look at Uno going for those fingers again, just snapping away.
Maybe he's trying to take away those big chops of Tama Dubois. I'm not sure why you would concentrate on the fingers exactly, but it seems to be something that Uno does.
He's punishing him. That's exactly what he's doing. I don't know if you look at the state that Evoluto has been for the past 6 months to a year. I'm not sure if there's a real rhyme or reason other than punishing his opponents.
Oh, things are getting fancy.
Up and over from Dubois. As he scales the top rope, launches himself off. Huge clothesline, and this is the opening that the Tabalnagda team need if he wants to make a tag to his partner, Mathieu Saint-Jacques, who is eagerly awaiting to get back into this match.
You gotta look for Saint-Jacques. Saint-Jacques is gonna get the people behind him here. He's gotta get the people behind him. There you go.
Dubois faced a lot of punishment. He is gassed. Uno makes the tag, and so does Dubois. Both of the freshmen are in. Knocks Uno off the apron. These men are just brawling here. Sends him into the ropes. Reversal from Belmar. Ducks a clothesline, does Saint-Jacques. Catches a big spear. Hits the ropes. A dive to the outside. I did not see that one coming. Saint-Jacques on fire as he's sizing up Belmar. He gets caught with a boot in the corner. Belmar off the second. Gets caught with a spinebuster. I think another one's on its way, and that's exactly it. Spinebuster City as Dubois is catching his breath on the outside. Saint-Jacques looks to be going for his patented clover leaf. Now, you felt this big magic. What is Belmar going through?
It's pressure on the lower back right here. He's going to be looking for the save. Uno's got to do something here.
I don't think
kick
he's going to have it
face
on for long. Uno's on
kick
his way in.
Kick him in the face, buddy.
That's not enough. You might want to take Big Magic's advice here. Look at this as he gets caught.
We got the crossface.
Dual submissions here. The only hope Belmar has as the legal man is to get to the ropes.
How come the referee's not putting a count on somebody here? Does it not matter?
Apparently it doesn't. You mentioned it earlier tonight. Why is it that when it works in your favor, you want the relaxed rules, but when it doesn't?
I don't know what you're talking about, Twiggy. I call it right down the middle, just as I see it.
TDT has been looking for this all night, and it looks like they are ready to aim and fire. Tandem dives. The suspenders are down. Belmar gets launched back into the ring as Uno is trying to capture his bearings on the outside. This is where TDT are about to go to work as we see a big forearm.
They're ripe for the pickings now.
Big pendulum backbreaker. Saint-Jacques gonna look for that big knee drop, and he catches it. Smart move. Uno wasn't gonna be able to get into the ring.
That's the tag team experience of player
launches
Uno coming to
launches partner into partner. Gets met with a big right hand for his troubles. As these
I don't know
men.
Who the legal man is. I don't know who can pin who. Nobody knows what's going on.
These men are just throwing fists. You can hear the meat on meat. The The suspenders come down from Dubois. He gets met with a handful of fingers. Just cracks the nose. A big roundhouse kick. Dubois goes sailing to the outside. Here comes Saint-Jacques. Launches the big body of Pleyrouno to the outside, and we're left with Belmar and Mathieu. At a certain point, Magic, this has got to be too much for these men to handle. Strike after strike after strike as Belmar looks for the sunset flip.
I mean, they're going back and forth here. It's been a couple minutes. It's just a matter of time.
What is this?
Somebody gets the pin.
What is this?
Oh, it's a disqualification. That's what that is. That is a clear-cut disqualification.
Well, it's
deliberately hit the ref. Pile drove him. Now we have no official. All hell is broken loose here in Gatineau.
It's tough to disagree, but the question is, if you don't have a ref to make the disqualification call, is it a disqualification?
Well, where's the athletic commission? Let's get another official down here. He can make the call.
I think I saw the delegate of the athletic commission in the back having a beer. He's having a good time like these fans are as we see a double choke slam, but there's no referee, and there's only one person
well,
to blame.
Whose fault is that?
There's only
whose
one,
fault is that? There's we don't only, want to hear you say it.
I'm not going to disagree. There's only one person to blame, and Mathieu Saint-Jacques can look at that person in the mirror tonight when he makes it home. The question is, will he be a winner as he's looking in the mirror?
A damn fool. Listen, I'm not going to lie. It was
look at this. Pussy. He's got a chair.
Who's this? Uno.
You want to talk about cheap shots?
Woo!
These teams are trading cheap shots, and I don't know if they get any cheaper than this. Uno capitalizing on the fact that the referee is out. He introduces a chair into the fray.
So I'm talking, who wants it more?
Well, we're about to find out.
Who wants this idiot's pile-driving referees? Now he's getting smashed with a chair. Should have let him walk away, right?
It was a desperation measure.
What? Boys, it's a Thursday night. It's a Thursday night, boys.
Belmar comes off the second rope with a big guillotine leg drop, and there's no referee. Can we get another official?
There we go. Louis.
One, two. I cannot believe this, Magic. The fans are on their feet. We're in a state of dismay. Serge is out. We've got a second ref out here. Saint-Jacques' back might be broken. This is the way that you want to close out Ludzango set the inaugural show.
It's all chaos. Now the ref's in. Is this a no disqualification match now? What's happening?
Well, by the looks
who's
of it.
Who's in charge?
By the looks of it, Hetfield's, he's admonishing Uno. He's trying to get a hold of that chair. Just shoving the ref. This is breaking down.
Absolute abuse.
Saint-Jacques ducks the shot, hits a big headbutt, gets caught with a super kick, and Belmar gets caught with a clothesline. Here comes Uno, comes in. I can't believe the only person that's up is the second referee.
That's just the kind of night it's been, Twiggy.
Having been in this position,
can we get this guy some medical attention?
What's going on in your mind when you're in this position?
He's just trying to survive. He's just trying to survive. Right now, I'm looking to take the easy way out, quite frankly.
What were you going to call for the count-out victory? You're looking for the count-out victory.
I would take the count-out loss. I'm out at this point.
We got a face-off here. You can see the fatigue in these men as they're just throwing haymakers here.
Why do they hate each other so much? Like,
is it so hard for you to understand that
I don't
these competitors
I
might be looking for the win?
I am here to make money. Not get hurt. Not hurt anybody.
But with the victory comes the money, Magic. Huge double choke slams. The flannel comes off, so you know they're all business now.
Yes, the weekend has started early in Gatineau.
They're looking for this patented double team maneuver that begins with the hanging kick to the back of the head, followed by the power bomb. One, two, three.
That is it.
Finally. We have got a winner here tonight in Gatineau.
No, I don't think so. Look
at Serge
has finally figured it out. This is
the
disqualification. It should have been a disqualification 10 minutes ago, and it's about
well, hold
time.
On. Let's go down to ringside for the official word. Let's get an update on this confusing matter.
Okay,
l'arbitre principal du combat a renversé la décision.
That's what.
Utilisé comme.
It's about time Twiggy took him all night, but Serge finally made a good call. It's the right thing.
It's hard to argue with this. Serge is in the right here, and he's getting, that's gonna cost TDT some money.
Can we get the athletic commissioner out of here? These guys are out of control.
They totally are doing a number. The fans are offering their chairs.
This has been my problem with TDT for years. They have no respect, no discipline. Somebody's gonna get hurt, and it's a shame.
Well, it certainly cost them, and it looks like it's going to cost them more because Saint-Jacques has introduced a table into this.
I'm getting out of here before I get hurt.
Mathieu Saint-Jacques and Thomas Dubois have set up a table in the corner. It's just hanging there. God, they're giving Serge an atomic wedgie to boot. They're setting him up for that buckle bomb that's going to... I don't know if I condone these matters at all, but you have to understand the frustration.
They did it!
They thought...
They did it!
I'm not disagreeing with you.
They're maniacs!
But the frustration that sets in after you believe you have won and you haven't, I don't condone it, but I understand it.
They should be suspended. We should never see them in this town again. It's a disgrace that I am disgusted, and I'm hitting the road whether you're coming or not.
It sounds like Saint-Jacques has got something to say as Big Magic hightails it backstage. Saint-Jacques puts a period on his actions tonight. And speaking of action, what an unbelievable night it has been. An action-packed card from top to bottom. For Big Magic, my name is James Twiggy McGee, and we will see you next time for Volume 2 of Lutte 07.